All right, Sammy, in position. Are you ready on cue?
We got quiet on the set?
Quiet. Quiet down, people. Keep people quiet in the background. All right, here we go. Live from Houston, Texas, is Super Bowl Central. It's the Ginger Cook Crumb Show. Ginger, hey, look at there. Sammy, yes, we're on air. You're absolutely right. Good man. Glad to see you're on the ball. Ginger, there you are. Oh, Ginger, you are cool.
I'm too cool for school. I have my fancy sunglasses on. I had eye surgery last week, and I'm avoiding the black lights. So this week, Monday, Tuesday, and I think Wednesday I'll be okay. Wednesday will be a week. I should be all right. But I'm going to tonight and tomorrow night, I'll be wearing these sunglasses. If that seems a little weird, just this way it goes, you guys.
And just deal with it, right?
It'd be interesting to see the colors I come up with since I'm looking through blue lenses. So you just got to go with that, too. Just sort of imagine, right? Maybe you all need to get some sunglasses, too. Then we'll be on the same page. Okay, so we'll all be looking at the world through, not rose-colored glasses, blue-colored glasses, right? Okay, so anyway, I want to welcome you guys to Monday nights. Usually on Monday night, we try to focus on things that people have been having difficulty with, that we get a lot of letters from, you know, how do I do this or how do I do that, and could you help me? And then things also you like to paint. And today we're going to focus a little bit on perspective, but in regards to your vanishing point. And oh, and now I'm going to just run some of you running right out of the room going, no vanishing points, no, stop, not, it's going to be fine. I'm going to explain it in such a way that you get it, okay? Such a way that you get it. Look, this was really tough for me when I first was learning to paint. My mind just wanted to run away screaming too. I don't want to hear about that stuff. Just show me an easy way to do it. Just, I don't need 16,000 explanations about how the stupid car goes. I just want to be able to turn the car on and drive it, you know? I'm saying, and I'm going to show you how to turn the car on, so to speak, on your painting and just drive it. And we're going to just get as few explanations as possible. And to facilitate that, we're going to do some more flowers. That seems to be a big hit. So we're going to keep with the flower theme because most of you seem to like it. My goodness, on our pots of flowers, which is we did a couple weeks ago, we've had a lot of use. That tells me you guys like to paint flowers. And then flowers in the rain. Oh my gosh, the flowers I've been getting back, the paintings. And I figured out, some of you have been trying to friend me on Facebook and thought I must have been some sort of incredible snob. I'm just...
No Facebook, comment from the peanut gallery.
Facebook illiterate. That's what it is, right? And my daughter, Cinnamon, has started me out on Facebook, and I don't know, some sort of setting happened some time ago, and I never looked at it again. And apparently, the only way you could be a friend with me in the old days on Facebook was if you were a friend of a friend, sort of thing, right? But now, I just put anybody can be friends, and then I just have to sort of screen it. There's a few of these little... I get a few strange trollers. I mean, some very strange comments like, hi, I want to get to know you better. Really, I don't want to get to know you in that way better. You know, the guys that kind of, you know, they're just a guy with no friends, you know, and they want to be your friend. You're going, ooh, too creepy. But anyway, basically, we've increased friends, and it's been, so you'll be in the know. And the reason you want to be part of the Facebook thing is you can then send me your stuff. And on Facebook, because I know it's fun to share with them. Look what I did. Yay, I did this. This is so cool. And then also, sometimes I show some new things we're doing, stuff like that. And then you get to see what all the other guys are doing. And then also, if you will join me on Pinterest, too, that's a good thing. Let me show you. Before I do, I want to introduce you to John Little. Those of you who are new to the show, but the old gang knows it here. John Little is our executive producer. He's the voice that you hear there. And he's going to be... Besides running the cameras and doing all the Zoomy stuff and stuff like that, and he and I kind of chat back and forth, if you have questions, he will relay them to me. That's how this works. So if you got a pertinent question and you just want an answer, sometimes it helps to put it in capital letters. We have two moderators, and they're kind of looking to some. And well, you know, if we don't get to it, you can always use the contact us on our website too. That's a good thing. So that being said, let me hold this up. I found two photographs that I thought were really pretty. This was the there was a park bench with some azaleas. Azaleas are starting to bloom in Houston. It's only February, but by March they'll be going full thing. And then I saw upside down this one, all right? So I'm going to show you how to take a couple of photographs, turn it into a little 8x10 painting, and we're going to talk about how to draw that bench in using a vanishing point, okay? So that'll be kind of cool. That's what we're going to do today. And if John, if you will be so kind as to scoot down here to my table, You will notice that I've got the paints out. I've got our phthalo blue, ultramarine blue, titanium white. This is cad yellow light. Doesn't matter. If you don't have it, just make some white with the yellow and you can make something. Cad yellow medium, yellow oxide, cad red medium, quadrichrome magenta, naphthol crimson, which is your is the red on your color wheel. Okay, that's your regular red, burnt umber, diazonine purple, and that's the group. Now, you notice there's no green. We're going to make that. And the first thing we're going to do is sort of divide this canvas up into two. We're going to start with this theme of this sort of path going up here, right, a diagonal. So what I would say the easiest thing to do is we're going to just come down about, this is 8 by 10 canvas, we're going to come down about, say, 4 fingers and just sort of maybe about 3 fingers up on this side and just sort of draw a diagonal like that, across there like that. You can't even see that, can you? You're going, what is she talking about? Huh, let's start with this. Here, can you see that one? Yeah, there you go, like that, right? So, all right, so now we're going to have two different underpaintings. And I've sanded, lightly sanded my canvas with just a very light sandpaper. And I'm starting with the Ruby Satin Silver Bright Brush. It's the number 8. A 10 would be good also, a little bigger brush. And dampen it, always wipe it off on a rag. Try to have some actual rags. Paper towels are right for palette knife painting because you throw those away, but rags are more absorbent. I know it's a green thing to do, but they're more absorbent. They take more water out of your brush than a paper towel for that kind of thing. Now, we're going to start with a dark background. So, and that's because we've got all these dark, see in the leaves and everything in here? So that's the color behind the color. So let's take, it's going to be mostly ultramarine blue with a little bit of yellow oxide and a little more ultramarine blue. Maybe a little bit of dazzling purple. That's a nice dark background.
We want to make sure that you can see. That's come up.
I can see. Oh yeah, the operation went really well. It was, and I appreciate all the nice things people said. People have had this done. What surprised me is like they did the right eye first, and that was the eye that was probably the eye that I don't see out of as well as the other one. Some years ago, I had a weird thing where they called it an actual stroke in the eye.
Ouch.
And that's weird, where I woke up one morning and half the vision was gone in my right eye. Just nothing. It was just like a gray. Everything was gray. And I went to the eye doctor, and they said basically what happened was that I had a blood vessel that had, kind of shut off in that part of the eye. And there wasn't anything they could do about it. And they just said, hopefully it'll come back. Maybe it will, maybe it won't, right? But that's always lovely to hear. Well, it did. Like 98% of it came back. There was always a little bit that wasn't perfect. And I said, well, I don't understand. I've never heard of that. What causes that? And they said, well, most people don't get that because they get up in the morning and they rub their eyes and they break up anything like that. But I was not rubbing my eyes because I read somewhere, and I think you've all read it too, that that's how you get cold germs is going around rubbing your eyes. So I had sort of stopped that. I didn't wake up rubbing my eyes in the morning and woe to me, right? But anyway, so that was the one they put the cataract thing in, the new
the
lens
cataract
in. Put the new lens in. And what I noticed was that I actually see, you're right, the colors are brighter in that eye. I've been spending, this has been really fun. I'll be sitting there going, like that, comparing. I'm going, oh yeah, look at that. I wasn't even sure once you get Medicare, you always wonder when somebody suggests these things. Quite frankly, you wonder just, am I just helping make a Mercedes payment? You just wonder, did I really need the cataract surgery, or are they just making this stuff up? But apparently I did need it. And it was pretty straightforward, certainly painless. I'm grateful that they suggested it, and I do the other eye on the 16th. So I have to say that I was very happy to have done that, okay?
Can we just make a comment? A couple people are saying that's a very blue background. Is that what you wanted?
Yeah, it's very blue.
Because we saw that you're playing with some of the oxide. And
yes, it's oxide. I'm going to try a little. I'm going to try a little yellow in it, like that, the cad yellow medium.
It was just a curiosity. We realize you have your blue glasses.
Yes,
on.
Yes, I have my blue glasses on, and if I let me tie a little phthalo blue in there too. I want it dark though, and that's what the purple did. I want it really dark, but we can come in here and add some tones to that, because you really want this dark. I could have just done it all purple too, but We want some tones in that. Let's just try a little Cadjello medium, a little phthalo on top, and I still want it very, very dark. You know, just dark, dark, dark. Now I'm going to not get too clever. I'm going to just get some burnt umber, which I'm going to miss. Boy, this burnt umber that I got, did I just buy that? That burnt umber, John?
Yes, we did.
That just came out like sludge. That's just like sludge.
Do you have the new one?
I think that's the new one, and it just came out like sticky sludge. I'm not happy with that at all. I'm not happy. Here's the new one. That's the raw umber. Where's the burnt umber? Well, where is it? Well, let me try this. Here's some, I'm not loving that. Here, let me see if I can't get this out. There's some burnt umber from Matisse. There. Oh, better. It's not supposed to be sticky like sludge. Guess what, you guys? It may just go back. You know, that's just, you know, I'll tell you what, burnt, the umbers, the dark umbers, the burnt umber, the raw umbers, they don't do well in the winter. I should buy all my burnt umbers in the summer. Because if they get cold, they get thick.
Was that first one a Liquitex that you were using?
That was a Liquitex, but I was not happy with that. And they don't age well either. That's all right. I've got this dark brown. You see that? So we just needed two colors to get this. This is our underpainting. We had to have something on here. So, I mean, this doesn't, this is pretty set. That's a pretty dark background. And, you know, which is fine. It's, we're going to keep this real simple. The Cookie Crumb lessons are real simple lessons. But the idea is to just show you how you might start with a painting and just very easily knock one out. You know, sometimes it doesn't have to be all that to be a good painting. And that's why you have to be careful. The more you do this, the better you get at it. Someone will say, well, how long did it take you to paint that? This is tricky. Don't talk. Don't tell them. For instance, if it took you months, that's not their fault. It's just, but if you did it in 10 minutes, maybe it took you, how many months or years did it take you to learn to do it in 10 minutes? So just, there really is no answer on how long it took you to do something, right? There just isn't. So now, for instance, are you doing a picture of me in a picture?
Yes?
Okay. Yeah, if I'm looking up and
there.
Talking to the camera,
you
I'm
are.
Going, yes? Okay. All right.
You're
all right.
Really there.
I'm really there. Okay. Well, that's good to know. Okay. So look, there's
working.
Nothing to that, right? So while that's drying, which we're going to do, I'm going to just put that brush in water. I'm going to just move this out of the way, and I'm going to get my cap here. And I'm going to just show you a bit on the chalkboard about vanishing points. We're going to talk about that a little bit. Okay, first off, to understand vanishing points, you have to understand what a horizon line is. All right? Now, okay, so if you have a picture like this, here's a photograph, right? The horizon line is always, 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 and this is whether it's a painting or a photograph, it is always where the sky meets the land or the water. Okay? That's what it is. Now, that's really easy to remember. Okay? So, generally, so there's your horizon line. See? And then there's your sky. And there's your land. Okay? Now, if there are mountains, they go above the horizon line. Okay? So, if there are mountains in a picture, the horizon line is somewhere back here if there weren't any mountains, okay? Now, so that's good to know, okay? That's and if, if it's water, it would be the same thing, all right? So let's say this is the ocean, but still, there's the horizon line, okay? Now, generally speaking, it's good not to have your horizon line if you're using a photograph, either bend down or get up a little tie or something, try not to have it dead center in the middle of your photograph. But now, what do you do if you've got something like this, okay? Here you've got a picture like this, and there's no a sky, and you've got to imagine where you've got some trees and stuff up here, but there's obviously some perspective lines going, because what happens is the perspective of stuff you're drawing goes off a horizon line. So let me take a little rag here, and let me just show you. So on a picture like this, let's just say this is our horizon line like this. I want you to say this is our horizon line like this. What happens is, I'm going to say that like up here somewhere is my horizon line, right? Well, what happens is that the bench, and here's why you want to know it. This bench, your vanishing point is where all the lines of the bench meet. Can you see what I'm doing here? So if I'm saying, if I do this, right, if I line this up here, and let's just say I said my vanishing point was right here, okay? If I put a straight edge here and I do this, all right, this angle's the same, this angle's the same, this angle's the same, and this top one's the same. Do you see that? All the lines are going to this point. Now what happened is this vanishing point, what's a little discombobulating is the vanishing point in this picture is off the photograph. But you have a photograph, so you don't have to make it up. They told you where it was. See that? See how this is? I'm just arcing this around like that and like that. So what happens is that my vanishing point, if my vanishing point is off of this picture, and let me just do like this, right? Okay, well, here's my photograph, okay, like that. So, and I said that, let me just show you. So I'm going to here, if I'm drawing a line like this, and like that, you see this? And like this, okay? And then all off here, like that. My bench, now these lines are always straight up and down, right? I need to bring this out a little further. This line is at an angle here. Now here's that, imagine you've got your square here, like this. These lines are always straight up and down. There's my cube, right? But this end here, right here, is wider than this end. Because all these lines are going to this line off your canvas. Does that help? Does that make sense? Okay, so that's and so most people, they want to draw this bench, and the reason they get confused with benches is they want to make this one as wide as this end as wide as the back end, and that doesn't work. And these lines always have to be straight up and not down. And these two lines here are parallel to each other. Okay, does that help? And then this line is going up like that. So everything's going to this vanishing point off of here, like that. And you don't have to even know where it is. You can just take a straight edge or something, a ruler or something, and you can look at your picture and kind of just somewhat with a straight edge where all the lines meet up. Does that make sense? You can kind of just see, well, there's my vanishing point here. So when you go to draw it in, that should help you, all right? Hope that is really, that is probably one of the more confusing bits of perspective when you're drawing something in, which is why people say they can't draw. But this is like having, when you have a photograph, this is the cheat sheet. This told you where it was. It's like having an open book test. They told you. And that same thing with, now sometimes you'll see photographs where the lines are really wrong, but mostly you take a photograph and do that with a ruler, particularly in buildings. Someday we'll show you that. And it's really easy to figure out where the lines go, even if the vanishing points are really off on both sides of the canvas. All right, so that being said, I'm going to dry this. John's got some great announcements. We've had some fun things happen this week as far as people sending us in artwork. John, if you want to tell them that, I'm going to start the dryer on this, all okay. Right? Unless there's any questions I should answer right now.
No, there are not.
Oh, good. All right. I hope that explanation was nifty, because I thought it was nifty, right? Okay.
Okay, while she's drawing that, I want to tell you guys something about the website. We're having an issue currently with the iPads, iPhones, people not being able to get to the lesson. It just pops up the image. If you see on the screen right now, if you do a long hold on one of the images, you're going to get a little pop-up menu. And that's not the right pop-up menu. That one is. Let's see. There we go. And what you do is you can select from there, open, or open in a new tab. You hold your finger down. Don't press hard on the new iPhone, because that's going to do the tactic feel. Just hold your finger on it, and it'll come up with that menu. Select if you want to open it or open a new tab, and you'll be good to go. And it will work while we solve the problem. And Ginger's back with us. All they want to know is Ginger's free birthday present over. No, it is in effect until the end of February. It will be free until the end of February.
Yeah, take advantage of that. We've had a lot of people go over to our website. And listen, when you download it, it'll say $11.95. And then it also says no charge and it's free. So Angela wrote us and said, I thought you said it was free. It is free, you guys. You got to read all the fine print. It's free. I promise you, it's free. It's free till the end of February. So
February 28th.
No worries there. And, you know, you've got to sign up to, you know, get on Vimeo. And then also, which is kind of cool, you're going to be notified of any other good stuff that we do, too. So good to know. Yeah, it's free. And incidentally, while this is dry, somebody had been watching this. I wanted to show you this. This has come up. Do you guys like this? We're going to be doing this tomorrow night. This
no.
Paint with Ginger. This will be our Mardi Gras special.
Really?
Mardi Gras the 28th. We're going to be painting this tomorrow night. How cool is that? Now, it gets even better, right?
There's more.
There's more.
Act now.
Yeah, there's more. Because if you're one of our members of Ginger Cook Live, we're going to give you this one in your box tomorrow night, too, in your members' library and also on our Wave and Water people for Mardi Gras. So you'll have a pair of, how cool is this? You can have a pair of paintings to hang on the wall for Mardi Gras. This is the 2017 Mardi Gras mask. Is this fun or what? Now, this one, tomorrow night, don't panic, it's going to be really easy. I'm going to show you guys how to trace this on. It'll be really simple. This one, you guys, we're going to show you how to grid this on and even make it bigger if you want or whatever. But in this lesson for our members, we're going to show you how to grid it on. Really simple. You're going to love painting these. So I thought this was our sort of our Mardi Gras surprise, you guys. How cool is that? Thought you'd like that. So in the meantime, back at the ranch.
Can you have more than one vanishing point? Let's talk on the vanishing point. Yeah, you can have up to really three.
Yeah, you can have more than one vanishing point.
I'll do more things on that. That gets, Ginger and I have.
Go ahead. We what?
I'm trying to think of a politically correct way that I can see better in 3D than you do. So what's a politically correct way to say that?
There's no politically correct way. It's just nice to think. It's nice to think you know stuff, John. But it's okay. But there is a thing. I mean, guys really get this. You know, guys are almost born knowing perspective, and they get a little intimidated. And if you've got a significant other in your household that's going around going, you know, this looks really good, except that line's off. What line? That one right there. Well, it is not. Well, sure it is. You know, and then you have these discussions. And let me tell you something. If you're selling any kind of artwork, you better have it right, because there's going to be some guy in the audience who's going, this is great, except that line is off. So you just don't want them off. So it's best to know these things. We'll cover more. But right now, we're going to put this back here. I've got my picture here, and I'm going to show you where we're going to come here. I'm just going to, remember, I said on this one, right? We're just, in this case, right, for instance, I've already got, let's see, where's my little thingy here? You're going, what thing? This, okay, well, it's clear. No wonder I couldn't see it. All right, so I want you to see this. You see, I can look at this line here. You see that? See the angle on here with this? It's going up this way. See that? Okay, so what I'm going to do, they've got this interesting how they've got this bench here. So I'm going to just do like this, and I'm going to draw this way. I'm going to go this way with it. And I'm going to give it a nice long bench here. And then I'm going to make this a little bit shorter, this line a little shorter, just slightly shorter, and come up this way. All right? It's like a piece of chewing gum. That's easy. Okay, and then come straight down like this. Piece of chewing gum like that. There you go. Straight down like this. That's the edge of this bench. And then we've got, imagine a line in here like this, okay? Underneath here like that, okay? And here's our bench like that. Here's there's our bench, our little stone bench. And that's pretty easy. Once you see that, and you see if I came all the way across like this, and went this way, like this, somewhere out here, and somewhere out way off of the camera, off of this picture, would be my vanishing point out that way. All right, but you just know that that's how this works. So let's just say that there's our bench right there, and I think I have that up high enough. You can see from our picture, and I think, let's see, in our picture, that's like about four fingers and two fingers. You like my rulers? So maybe four and three. It's perfect. Looks good to me.
And my hands are a different size than yours. Does that really matter?
Not to me. I think I want it wider. You know that? I'm going to make this a little wider. I'm going to come out here and make it just slightly wider. Just, you know, if your fingers are big, the rest of you is probably too big. So it'll give you a little more bench to sit on.
What are you saying about my tush?
Nothing.
Okay.
Nothing. I say nothing about your tush, darling. I say nothing. We talk about that. We don't talk about tushes here. No talking tushes. All right. I noticed something. I'm going to put the foot a little bit in here. There's a little overhang here. Interesting. I guess the foot's going here, which is interesting. It's coming under here like that. They braced it a little differently. So that's the same one without. Anyway, this is all plants. I give up. I don't understand their bench. Okay, so there's my bench. All right, so then what I would do is I'd take a little angle brush. Let's just paint this bench in. And if this is sort of an old bench, so let's just take a little bit of white and burnt umber, which is all gone. This is really annoying. Okay, here we go.
You're really fighting that burnt umber tonight, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. All right, so there's a little bit of burnt umber, and I want a little yellow oxide with it. Warm that up. Okay, and I'm going to just come across here like that. Paint over the chalk. Chalk is fun, but the problem with chalk is that when you paint over it, it starts clogging up your brush, similar to sand, you know? And so every once in a while, you just have to stop and rinse your brush off, too. So we've got some sort of a... Here, let's make a gray color. Here's some natural crimson, a little ultramarine blue, a little bit of white, a little bit of yellow oxide. Little ultramarine blue, more white. Let's put a little bit of burnt umber in it, something. Some umber in here like that. A little more yellow oxide, a little more ultramarine blue.
Do remember you have blue glasses on.
Still works.
Okay.
Good thought. All right, I'm just going to lighten this bench up a little bit here. There we go. It was a little dark, but that's good. That's all right. All right, there's my little bench, like this. Then I'll put a little bit more white on that, and then say, here's the front edge of this, like that. And I'll just make the front edge a little lighter, so it shows up. Okay, there you go.
When did Ginger know she wanted to be an artist?
When did I know I wanted to be an artist? I think I liked when I was a kid. I really enjoyed making this a little darker now on the edge. I really enjoyed, coloring and painting with watercolors, and I was good at it. And my adopted mother was an artist, and she was a very difficult person to connect to. She was a challenging individual. And, for one thing, she was an alcoholic, but I didn't understand what that was. And, you know, when you're a kid, you have no idea what that means. You just know that you've got a Jekyll and Hyde personality going on there, and then some days everything's great, and the next day it isn't. And nothing's changed in your world, right? Let me just give that a little bit bigger foot here than I drew in, like that. And then I'm going to come under here like that with a darker color, a little bit of purple, darken this up. So because she was an artist, she encouraged that. She encouraged that. And so you got, you know, not only was I good at it, but she encouraged that. And so that was something I could do that where we had a connection. All right. And though she never had any of my artwork in her house, she never hung anything in her house that I did. Just sort of funny.
It was too colorful, right?
It was too colorful, and then she just had her stuff up. You know, it's all about her, always. that's okay. You know, listen, she adopted five kids, and half her friends didn't know it. You know what I mean? So it's not like she was big on bragging about the grandchildren or anything, you know? That was it. She was just, like I say, she was a challenging individual. But she came from a time when, you know, nowadays, you know, women have jobs. If you go to a party with a group of women, they're pretty much, if they have kids, they're talking about them, okay? You know what I'm saying. They're talking about their kids. oh, my son did this, or my daughter did this, and we went to this, or we had that, and can you believe what this, you know, the story. That's how what we do. Well, back, you've got to imagine that many years ago, most women didn't work, and their job was being a housewife, and if you went to a party, and, you know, you just didn't have anything to talk about. And, you know, and she, of course, she was her art and stuff, but, and, you know, my dad was a judge. I mean, so she could, you know, I mean, and they were very social. They went out a lot. So I think she liked the idea of having kids. And, I mean, everybody likes the idea, you know, the idea of having kids, the reality of having kids. Come on, anybody that has kids, no, the idea of having kids, the reality is two different deals. Just make this a little darker on your hair. Okay. Yeah. And only in the sense that children are not just something you can just, you know, show off to the guests and then shove back in the closet up there like flowers in the attic, you know. You actually have to do something with them. And so they discovered that they didn't enjoy doing things with us. That's not terrible, but they didn't, right? So they hired people to do things with us. They hired people to take my sister and I camping. We went to summer camp for 2.5 months, as long as till school started. We were at summer camp. And you know, and I'm sure if she heard my take on it, because she since passed away, she'd go, well, that's not how it was. Well, you know, perception is everything. You know, that's how it was. That's how it seemed to me, right? May not have been true, but that's how it seemed to me. All right, we're going to lighten up this this little driveway here. So we're going to just take some white now. We've got some, and maybe a little bit of the brown on it. Not much. And just making kind of little circular motions here. We're just going to come over here like this and kind of lighten up our pathway here like this. We're not going to try and get anything too fancy here. A little bit of white, a little bit of romber, and just come on here and just very carefully, barely touch it under here, kind of lighten this up. And let's a little bit of white, a little bit of romber. There we go. Just making little circular motions. So anyway, she was very generous when it came to painting. And so I guess the question is, you know, how does one end up doing stuff like that? One ends up, I think, as kids, you know, there was some reinforcement. I mean, I had a pony, and that was fine. And, you know, I used to go to horse shows and do gymkhanas and horses. We lived in Seattle right next to the Bridle Trails, a park where we could, on the weekends, I was like a teenager, you know, 11, 12, teenager, we'd go up and, you know, ride horses. And she saw that, she saw we had lessons and things to do. If we wanted to learn something, we had lessons. So they weren't, you know, this wasn't like Harry Potter or something where we're sleeping under the stairs. But just, again, if you haven't been around somebody, if you've never been around someone that changes personality in mid-sentence, as the afternoon wears on, as because, you know, anything, it was okay to drink after 4, I think that was the rule. Yeah, so up until 4, we were pretty safe. And then after that, you know, it was anybody's guess what she was going to, how she would react. It was a real challenge. All right, so that's my first step here into the, it's not as light as I'm going to make the walkway here, but that's pretty good. I've got something at least going here with my bench. Now I can start in on the leaves, on the leaves, you guys. This is pretty straightforward. Now we've got and also we'll start lightening the bench and adding some green moss and aging it and all that stuff. But you saw how we drew it in, right? And I think I'll take a little purple and blue and just make it a little bit darker under here again. I want this very dark back here. Because you don't really see in the photograph, you don't really see the back end of this bench at all. So we're just sort of hiding it there like that. And it's dark under here like that. There we go. Okay, so also very good. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to put in some green leaves. So I'm going to start with yellow and a little phthalo blue. Now that's the bright green in this. Okay, if I were to put here. Okay, that's the bright green in the photograph. Now here's the problem with new artists. Because that's the color in the photograph, you're going to be tempted to want to do that green. You've got to add, red is opposite green on the color wheel. You've got to add some red to that. So to tone that green down, either red or brown. So about 1% red, let's put a little more yellow. All right, so there's our, and then I'm going to add a little more white to lighten that green up, maybe a little more yellow. Okay, I had a little tiny bit of red. I could add Cad Red Medium because that's got a little bit of, Cad Red Medium has some yellow in it, all right? So that's pretty good. Now, the farther the greens are back here, the grayer we want them. So we might add some ultramarine blue and white to that mixture here. Now I'm just going to start back over here like this, and I'm just going to tap in some greens back here like this. Little tiny, using just the edge of my brush here like that, coming out over the wok, and just put some greens in like that. They're not real bright, and I'm not trying to say any particular kind of plant either. We're just indicating some sort of green leaves that are coming back here like this in less detail, and maybe I'll take a little bit more white with that. And then back in here like this, on top of that, we'll say the light's coming kind of down this way. Kind of coming from this way, all right? I think, yeah, kind of coming from the top. We'll add some lighter green leaves on the top like that. Just one, two, and stop, okay? But,
Wait, how old were you when your adoptive parents passed away?
Oh, I was in my 40s, I guess. 50s. But I was like 5 years old when I was adopted, and they were in their 40s and 50s. My adopted father lived to be 99. And they lived a long time. She was really big on eating healthy. You know, she was big on health foods and eating that. She was big on eating healthy things. So just I will give her credit that it did seem to work for them. They had fresh squeezed orange juice every morning, you know, before they got up, you know, with half a grapefruit, and they, you know, they didn't eat a lot of candy and, you know, no sweets, stuff like that, no potato chips. They're a generation that, you know, could live their whole lives without eating any, you know.
Well, that's okay. Just silly.
I know, just how unfun is that, right? But and she was very judgmental of people that got overweight too. Boy, you didn't want to be overweight around her. I was thin for a lot of years. You know, her comments about overweight people were just really unkind. And though she was not thin, which is, you know, she wasn't real fat, but she wasn't thin either. I mean, she, you know, nowadays, you know, the only reason I had such great restraint was that they held our inheritance in check over us. You know, I couldn't get too snarky with her. Because I didn't want to get... There was a time when I really cared about not getting written out of the will. You think... you see those shows on TV, and you know, we're not kidding. Nobody wanted to get written out of the will here. Okay, so we're just going to say there's some green leaves in here. We're going to put some flowers on our bench. I'm going to say I've got some green leaves coming up this way. A little bit lighter green. This can be a really cute little picture if you don't get too crazy with it, okay? Notice that the leaves in front are bigger because why? Because they're toward us, right? Okay, we'll put a little bit of light here on some green leaves. Okay. Now at this point, I think I can take a little yellow, come over here and make a little orange. There we go. See this sort of orangey green color, right? Like that. That's my moss color. Wipe most of that off. Now I'm going to come up on my bench here and dry brush on some of this mossy green color in a few places on my bench. See that? That kind of cool. It's kind of cool looking when, you know, like that, a little bit of mossy green. Okay, and then even a little bit of, here's some Cad Yellow Light. You cannot mix Cad Yellow Light. Did you know that? You can add white to Cad Yellow Medium, but you won't get Cad Yellow Light. So here's a little bit of that moss. And I think I want this edge of the bench a little bit lighter, okay, like that, and it's still a little dark. I think I have my glasses on, but it's still a little dark. So even with my glasses, the bench looks a little dark, so I'm going to lighten up the bench a bit, put a little more brown and white out like that. Let's see if we can't lighten up, put some of that green in it, see if we can't lighten up this bench a bit. There we go. Acrylics dry darker, so don't despair if you find yourself painting along and things, you thought it was all right, and then it isn't. Don't panic, just put the next layer on. It's one of the things that takes time with acrylics is that they need to dry, and when they dry, they go darker, and you need to layer. So we're just coming under here now with this lighter color on the bottom of this, and it's helpful for me if I want something. I've just almost got white on the brush now like this. See, that I'm going to pull up with
this.
Notice
how she flipped it over. Don't be afraid to turn the canvas.
Yeah, that's the thing. I mean, you know, and look, you left-handed people are going, I don't know what she's doing, right? And I get that, okay? Now, here, right here on this top here, on this corner, I want this maybe a bit lighter here, too. So I'll just flip, you know, maybe paint this corner in. And then I want kind of a light line right here. It's kind of a white line, kind of an edge up here, too, like that. Let's get a little edge going, right, like that. All right, so there's my lighter bench. Now, you see, it's getting that kind of old, weathered look. Here's some of this, maybe a little bit of darker green moss. Let's put a little bit of yellow oxide with that. Because, you know, if you want something, let's see, let's take a little bit of ultramarine blue and yellow oxide. Yeah, there we go. Let's make some darker moss. Tap some of that on this bench somewhere. Get back over here. It's just, it's kind of cool. It kind of ages things. You know, when you do that, it's going to be really pretty. It sort of ages it. All right, so now while this is all happening, let's put some azaleas in. And then the other photograph I had, I told you we're combining two photographs. Do you see this one? We've got some azaleas, but we've got some other pretty flowers. So I think what we're going to do is do a kind of a combination of these. And let's start with the pink azaleas first, because they all come down here and cluster, and they're really neat. So let's start with some new white.
So could we say that you're basically designing this as you're going?
I'm designing this painting as we're going. I have no idea what, you know, designing it this as going. Listen, it's been a busy day, you guys. What do you want?
It's a Monday. Come on.
It's Monday, right? I'm designing this painting as we're going. So I'm going to take a little bit of magenta and white, okay, like that. And start with the darkest color first. And we're just going to come up here like this. And, you know, same way we did it, we're just going to say that there's all kinds of wonderful pink flowers coming around here like that. Now when you're doing flowers, you start with the darkest color first, all right? And there's even some kind of growing over the top of this bench in a couple of places. So mostly this is pretty dark. So we'll start with our dark. In fact, I'll come right into magenta in a couple of places and just say, here's my dark color. And I've got it all growing under here too. I'm looking at this going, this is pretty. So this is my dark color, almost my underpainting color here, my dark magenta.
Generally speaking, should leaves be painted in before the flowers?
It depends. Generally, if you look at, for instance, G. Harvey, Thomas Kincaid, those guys, usually they were painting flowers in sort of clusters and came. You usually paint them over dark green, and then with occasional flowers. Okay, so now this is kind of going. This is sort of pretty. The way they've got these flowers going, they're circling out like this and coming around like that. There's almost a circle of flowers coming this way in the garden, all right? So now I'm going to just bring this down into here like that, but not just touching this little circle, but not everything. Okay, there we go. Now, and I want to come back up here into here a little bit and have these start almost like a waterfall. This reminded me of a waterfall of flowers that was coming here. These azaleas, really pretty. We have them in Houston, but they're good for about 2 weeks, and if it rains, they're less than 2 weeks. You have these bushes that you have to care and love all this time, and you get 2 weeks worth of flowers. But I understand other places, they have them going a long time. All right, so that's the darkest part of the flowers, all right? So while that's drying, I'm going to take some yellow and just... same color, magenta and yellow, and I'm going to come back over here, and I'm going to make, let's put some...
I have good health, but it hasn't come up, interrupted by the streamer. That's a YouTube thing, guys. It wasn't us.
It wasn't us. Are they back? Does that happen?
Yeah, it appears to be.
Are we back now?
It's resyncing.
We're resyncing?
I don't get it.
I'm coming up back here like this. Over here, like that, and adding a little bit of white to those. All right. Now, see, I've changed colors of flowers, right? That's pretty. And then I want to come over here and add a bunch of flowers. I think that would be really nice. Just kind of change colors. We're going to come over here and add some into this group. I think we'll just come back up here with some white flowers. Like this, because if I want some brighter yellow flowers, they would be over white anyway. So I'm going to come back this way and say I want some white flowers growing this way. Let's see, what do we got here? A little bit of white. I think I got brown on there somehow. Okay, all right. Got it kind of off-white. So some sort of little white flowers growing this way. That's kind of cool. And then maybe down here. Are we back, John, or not?
Yeah. No, we're back.
We're back. Okay, I never know when you say we're gone, we're gone. All right, I'm going to take a little bit of naphthalene crimson, which is red, and I'm going to come right back here and add some little red flowers back, kind of tucked back in here like that, that are growing. This is a cool little place to be sitting, isn't it? A little bench. Okay. All right. So you kind of see, you know, see where I'm going with this, okay?
Yeah, they wanted to see both photos. Could you pull down the top photo just a little bit?
Yeah.
Thank you.
So you see I've got both photos going here, right? And so I've got these little white flowers that are in here like this. And I'm going to just say I want maybe one coming up like this, some sort of white flower. And then over here, we're going to have some green and stuff growing over our bench. I want the back edge of this a little lighter. Sometimes if you need something lighter and you're not getting it lighter, one way you can get it is mixing white, assuming one had any. We have some. I remember it. Zinc white. Ah, yes, I remember zinc white. Here. Zinc white. All right, here's zinc white. And here's zinc white is a transparent white. And you can see through it. So sometimes if you need something a little lighter and it's not as light as you want, for instance, I want the front of this bench a little bit lighter, I can just put a little zinc white over it. And it will let the brown show through. See, like that? See, it just sort of lets the brown show through. If I want the back edge of this table a little bit lighter, I can just take this zinc white, and it will just lighten up my bench enough. I don't want the whole thing light. This is the trick. I just want this little back line lit like that. There we go. So now you're seeing our little bench. We need the contrast. And this might be a good one to do as long as we were doing it. Pinch the brush. Here's a little zinc white. Let's take a little of that and just sort of push it around in here like this. Kind of lighten up our walkway a bit too. You know, like that. We're just lightening up this walkway. All layered it up here. So, anyway, that was the... there we go. I think the thing is, when people ask about when you become an artist, if you get encouragement at home, you're more likely to be an artist than if you don't. You know, some kids just like to draw. But there's a kind of a thing, it wasn't when I was a kid, it's still prevalent now, is that there's usually per class, they let one kid be the artist and everybody else is told they're not. And I've seen more people that are wonderful painters, you know, later in life, that were told as young, when they were young, that they sucked at this. Because nobody sucks at this. This is a skill, like playing the violin or speaking Chinese. It's a skill. It's a learned skill. There's certain hand-eye coordination, certain things you do to make stuff happen. A good idea is a little different than a skill. A good idea is taking, you can't teach imagination, but you can. Trust me, I don't care where your journey is in art, you can get better than you are now, regardless of where you are, you can always get better. And the thing of it is that it's all a learned idea. It's definitely a learned skill. So just keep that in mind. I think that's kind of good to know. I'm going to warm up this ground a little bit with a little yellow oxide.
What did you use to make that beautiful orange color?
The magenta and yellow and white. I think we were off then, right? We were kind of...
Yeah, we blipped.
We went in here, I'm adding a little yellow oxide to this and warming up our dirt just a little bit. Here's a little bit more brown here. We're just kind of warming up our gravelly road here. I've been debating whether or not I wanted to put stepping stones, but I don't think we do. But in any event, we're going to warm this up a bit. Okay, warming it up is that, and you know, yellow's a warm color, say blue being a cool color. Okay. All right, so there we go. That's a little better, and then we'll come up with some little light areas later. Come up, here's a little titanium. We're going to say this is a little bit lighter back in here, like this, where our path is going back, like that. That's the difference between titanium white and mixing white. See how we're lightening this up now? We're creating some areas where the eye wants to follow. Okay. All right, so there's that. Now, this is probably needs to dry still. If you would be so kind, John, as to take over for a minute, I'm going to dry this.
Oh, you want me to actually do something? Actually work? Are you crazy?
Yeah.
You're talking crazy talk.
Crazy talk, John. Crazy talk. All right. Dryer's going.
Turning you off. All right. I'm going to bring up a painting, Rain Flower by Sandy. There we go. And notice what she did to this one? She added a sign. Love that touch. That is really thinking outside the box there. I got a couple of red shoes I want to show you. This first one's going to be Becky's. This is work that people have sent in that we've seen. And that is not Becky's red shoe. Let's try this one. There it is. Now, I like how she did the fading in of that. I think that is really cool. Now, we have another red shoe, which is very bright. And it was done by Stacy. And let's see if I can press the right button this time. And there it is. Is that awesome or what? And then, question two. Oh, she's back. Let's bring her back up then, shall we?
Hey, Aaron. And listen, that one by Sandy with the picture where you saw where she added the sign. This is what I'm talking about. You can't teach a good idea. You can teach someone how to do something, but imagination is up to you. So that's where, you know, people, you know, sometimes comedians, what do comedians do? We all went to the airport, but they tell us a story about the airport we've all experienced, but they say it in such a way that we never thought about it. So sometimes as artists, what we can do is show the people the world in the way they hadn't thought about it, you know, and just sort of expand on it, you know, what kind of zero in on something and show it. Which is kind of nice. A lot of time you'll see young people and they and their art's a lot of political statements. By the time we get into this group of, you know, seniors that are painting, that kind of stuff, you know, and you get, you know, you're just less interested in making political statements. You just want to make pretty paintings. You know, I mean, I think there was a time when I was young that I was making political statements with my art, for sure. You know, that's the fun thing you can do, but not so much now. All right, so now... All right, you see where I am here. I've lightened up the pathway a bit. It's not completely done, but I haven't decided if I'm going to put any flowers over here. I kind of like those, don't you? So let's finish these azaleas. So we've got white and magenta, okay? I think I'll just turn this upside down. A little bit of white and magenta. And we're going to come up here like this, and I'm going to just tap in this flower like that. I'm tapping it in using the corner of the brush. And they're overlapping, and I'm not mixing it very well. The secret is when you put the white and stuff on your brush, you don't want to mix it very well because when you're tapping it, then you're going to get this sort of two-tone effect that these flowers have. All right, you see that? And here we go. So we're going to just tap it this in, put a little white, a little bit of white on one side, a little bit. There we go, tapping it in like that, just turning the brush around, tapping them in.
Tap, tap, tap.
A lot of tapping in business here.
Oh, you got a lot of flowers you're putting in.
Well, we do. And I thought this was a good one. I know this was supposed to be some sort of little short lesson. Sometimes it's hard to come up. What could I show you on Monday that we hadn't thought about? Sometimes I think about that. What could I show you that you hadn't thought about for a while, but you might find fun doing? Notice we're kind of going over some of our dark areas and then getting into the light areas. Okay. We'll put some green back. See all the green in here? We'll put that... We will add that last. We'll come back in and poke holes in this with some green and some dark. But here we go. There's our azaleas. And just flowers are one of the few things that you can do right out of the tube. And so people say, what color should I buy? I don't think you can own enough colors of reds. I tried to stick with the same colors all the time, and I have a reason for that, is because I don't want you to have to go out and buy a lot of stuff. If you can pretty much know if you're watching me, if you own these colors, that you're going to be okay. But on the other hand, why not expand on it? Okay, so here, like this, and let's notice that we're very aware. About every four flowers, you see me getting paint. Okay, there's a couple creeping in on here like that. Tapping where the white went, like that, over the edge of that bench, like that. You can kind of see where we're going with it. A little bit more white. Now, as your brush gets, is carrying more pigment, I'm almost just going into white because there's a lot of pink on it. Okay?
Are you tapping more on the taller tip of the brush?
On the, the brush is at an angle. So I'm using the long tip of the angle,
right,
what I'm using. All right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the brush is at an angle. So I'm just tapping it right there on this angle.
And should we say that's your favorite brush?
Yeah, my favorite brush are these angle brushes. They're so easy to use. I mean, you can use a bright brush too and get this effect, but it's a little bit more challenging. Now, like, see, we're coming up there like that. Now, this is getting, already we sort of jazzed up this picture, didn't we? Here's our waterfall of flowers coming down, kind of overlapping some of these. Now, they're lighter up top. Remember, they're a little bit brighter up this way. Okay, a little bit brighter up toward the top where the light's hitting them, a little bit brighter. And then just a couple back up in here, and peeking down from the top. All right, now this maybe needs a little bit more magenta in this one. Okay, now I like that. Now I'll pinch the brush and come back just with some white. Because this is wet now, and I'm going to highlight some of these while it's still wet. I'm just barely touching it, thinking the light's going to hit the top ones, okay? In the ones, like right in here. See this little section right there? They're a little lighter. So just kind of observe that when you're painting something, and know that it's a little darker. It's a little darker underneath the flowers and a little bit lighter up on the top. Okay, so if you have to come back with some magenta and darken something up, that's fine too. All right, so those are our magenta flowers. Now let's put something in. Well, a couple more here. And you can make them smaller as you go up too. They're kind of barely peeking out there.
A couple of people are just turning in and want to know about your glasses. Why are you being so cool today?
Oh yeah. Okay. So if you just tuned in, this is the. Yeah, my glasses are the, I had cataract surgery last Thursday, and they put the first lens in my right eye, and I'm just trying to stay out of the bright lights for a little bit for that, and then by Wednesday I should be able to have these off as far as for lights like this goes, just because when we're filming, you can't believe the lights we have on in here to make this work. All right, so now we're going to put some kind of yellow-orange flowers right here. I think that would be really pretty. I like these, don't you? So let's take some of this, let's try a little of this cad yellow light and some white, titanium white, and maybe a little yellow oxide.
Hey, Ginger, have you ever gotten to a point where you walk away from the painting, just have to get away and work on something else and then go back to it?
Yes. The question is, do I ever do that? Sure. And here's why. Because sometimes you just have to let your brain reset on it. It doesn't hurt to do that. Walk away. In fact, you should, sometimes it's nice. You have some friends come over. I don't really like the peanut gallery, but sometimes people can say, hold it up to a mirror. Go and hold your picture up to a mirror. That's almost as good as walking away. You can have a mirror in your studio. That's a good thing, all right? So here's my yellow. Here's some yellow flowers. Okay, and here's a little yellow oxide where they're a little darker.
What's the longest Ginger's gone without painting?
Oh, gosh, months sometimes. Back when Cinnamon was a kid, in about 16, I'm going to add a little orange to this now, right? Make that red, me in yellow. Well, back when Cinnamon was a kid, Her dad and I found ourselves in a financial difficulty. We had a bunch of investments and all the income from them stopped. And we had no means of support. And her dad, bless his heart, which is one of the reasons he lives alone today, thought it would just be great to just borrow money on the house, which was paid for, and then just live off that. And I said, well, then how do you intend to pay that back? Well, he said he'd rather, I think the quote was, live in a tent on the side of the hill than get a job. And I thought, well, I'm going to work. So, you know, and he said, well, I don't know what you think your skill is, because I mean, I've taught art and stuff, but you know, I wasn't making a living at it then. And he says, I don't know. He says, your best skill is talking on the phone. I says, you know, it's a skill. I'll make it work. You know, he was just being snarky. I was being snarky back. Okay, so now we're going to come back here, and I'm going to put some orange flowers in here, some cad red medium flowers in here. See this? Let's put a little yellow with that. A little bit yellow. There we go. A little bit of yellow. Let's put some brighter orange flowers in here, like this. Let's just say here's some ones in here, like this. Oh, this is pretty, right? We're getting some flowers in here. So anyway, seriously, I mean, that's what he said. He was not willing to do anything. I mean, I was just shocked. I mean, we had always lived off our investments. And, you know, and it wasn't that he was lazy, because he did things, but he just, he built our house. And he did a bunch of stuff, and he was really smart. Some of his dad's really smart. But that wasn't smart. And that was just sort of the last straw for me. So I went out and got a job selling cars, back when there were no women car salesmen. You guys know that? Yeah. Selling cars. And I didn't know the first thing about cars. We didn't even own a new car. We hadn't owned a new car in years. I mean, not that we couldn't buy one, but we could have, but he just didn't, you know? So I didn't know anything about cars. We just had one and we drove around, you know, old Honda car. And, oh, see how the flowers are coming around our bench now? Isn't that looking good, you guys? Don't you think so? So you're going, no, you never heard this story, did you? No, you never heard this. So I'm going up, and I'm thinking, well, I can sell cars. You know, because you know what? I get shopping. But you're just shopping for something bigger. I really get that, right? So I got a bunch of Zig Ziglar tapes on how to sell things, right? And then I went to a car dealership and applied for a job. And there were no women doing this. And the guy said, what do you think? He's just so shocked to see me. I think they had one woman in there in the car dealership, and she was there, and she was older, you know, because I was younger. She was older. She looked old to me anyway. And, but other than that, but, you know, anyway, not to say too much about that. That was just her. And then I applied for the job. And the guy, when I was interviewed, he said to me, he said, well, why should I hire you? And I said, well, I said, you have to figure that I'm going to sell a lot of cars for somebody. It's either going to be you or your competition up the street. I guess you just have to decide who you want me to sell the cars for.
That's a nice way to put it. It sounds like a Zig Ziglar thing to say.
You know, it's a little bit, you know, I'm going to sell them for somebody. I'm going to brighten up here. A little pure cad red now on these red roses back here. Brighten these up. See how they got kind of dark against the green? Brighten up these, right? On red flowers, okay? Now, this is just coming along nicely, isn't it, you guys? Aren't you sort of surprised at how nicely this is coming along?
Especially with you wearing some cool sunglasses.
With the sunglasses, yeah. So, the upshot of what's now, you look in here, there's a bunch of greenery. I think some greenery would be nice, and I'm not sure that we wouldn't do well to put some yellow flowers here, from here. See these little yellow ones? Might be pretty right here, too. Just kind of put a little group of flowers here. Let's do that.
Can you use zinc white in place of mixing white? Which do you prefer?
You know what? I most of the time, I really have a hard time deciding. There's a big difference between them. I'm going to put a little magenta in that dark green here. All right. So I want some dark green in here. I'm going to just say that there's some dark green somethings coming up this way. How's that? You like that? The somethings? Just there. There, and that's, we're going to have some flowers there. So it's going to kind of cut that corner in here. That's nice, right? Kind of come from the path like this. Now, like that green. So let's pull some green. Let's say that there's some green in here. I'm going to break some of these flowers up here with a touch of green. I can do that over the yellow, not over the red or the pink, because yellow and, you know, blue make green. So if I wanted to break these flowers up a little bit with some green and even some light green like this, not that, you know, a couple little brighter greens here through these flowers. See, I can break that up like that on the bench. There. All right. See how we kind of broke that one up? But this is still too wet to put green in. If you try to put green into red, what happens is you end up with mud. I saw that with some flowers that came back recently with some flower pots. They just were all muddy. You have to dry in between. You absolutely have to dry in between. All right, so we're going to come up with, let's take some white in that lighter green here that we just made. That's pretty. Kind of this blue-green color, a little bit of yellow in here like that. That's right. Let's come up here like this, and let's just add some kind of blue-green leaves like this on our, ooh, make that a little bit darker. Okay. On our some plants that are coming in the foreground here. See that? We're just going to say this side of our bench. We've got some kind of blue-green plants. Right like that. So far, so good. That looks good. And then we'll take some white and yellow and come over the top of a couple of these and say that that's our, that where the highlights are on those. Like that. Just one stroke and stop, okay? There, all right, so we're saying those are a little brighter than these ones down here. And then there were some little grasses growing here. See, this was pretty. Some other little kind of plants that were growing here. So let's take another green, and I'll mist. So back to this, anyway, I got hired painting, selling the cars. And they didn't know what to do with me, and it was really funny because they wanted to hire me because they thought that was sort of cool what I said, later found out. They thought what I said was very cool. But notice that I can take the edge down. Look at these thin lines I can make on this. See, with these grasses. Look at that. Okay? See the thin lines I can make? Anyway, and so they said, well, you know, we don't have a fleet department. How would you like to be in charge of our fleet department? And, you know, man, I'm a sucker for titles. What am I going to be doing? We're going to have a fleet department. You can be in charge of it. Oh, this was a Mitsubishi dealership, and I didn't understand anything about fleet. I thought I'd look it up when I got home, but it sounded good to me. All right, title. I'm writing, not only my title, I have a job. I have a title and an office. They gave me an office. I'm going, they didn't want me out on the floor. It's scary. I don't know what the deal was, but yeah, anyway, I had an office. And I don't know what their plan was. It really was kind of funny, but within the first month, I had more cars out than anybody. I'd sold more cars than anybody else. Because I absolutely believed that they thoroughly expected me to, I mean, I believed in the story, you know? And then it got to be a thing. But anyway, I ended up working there for a while, and then I went over and sold Fords for a while, and then I sold Hondas for a while, and discovered the ins and outs of selling cars.
Scary people, at best, isn't
people,
it?
People don't last long in that. It's a tough job. It's a tough job. But, you know, it paid the bills. I'm telling you what, that job paid the bills. Now, see what I've done here? See, I've sort of covered up this edge of the bench. See? Cool. Didn't have to talk about the other foot. Didn't want to talk about it anyway.
So you just covered it up.
I just covered it up, and it was covered up in the picture, right? And moving on. And that was really fun. And I got a great story about that, John. They gave me all the weird people. You know what I mean? They really tried to discourage me. They gave me all the weird people. When I first started, and so I had this guy come in, and he came in on a bicycle, and he wanted to look at Starions, which were the most expensive car we had. I'm doing a little yellow here up here, a little yellow, a little bit of white here on these little light grasses here up here like this, and so. I mean, that was the most expensive. And he came, and he didn't. He wasn't dressed well. He didn't look like anybody that could afford a starian. But you know, my thought was, if you showed up there, you obviously wanted something. You know what I mean? I'd talk to you. So I went out and talked to him. Nobody wanted to talk to him, and I'd talk to him. He was this funny guy. And he asked about the car, and we got to chatting. I said, I was kind of new at this, but I'd do the best I could. If he hung in there with me, I'd do the best I could. So I'm putting a little bit of white tips on this. And, that's kind of fun, right? Oh, liking this. So, is this dried enough yet for grass? Maybe. It's probably dried enough for a few little greeneries. We want some, now we're gonna take the phthalo blue and yellow, and we're gonna pop some brighter greens in these with some white. I'm gonna put some white with it and pop some brighter greens right in here like this. Just chuck some greens coming out here, just in front, couple of these. A little bit brighter greens right up in here. Okay, like that, see? We just didn't need too many. And then we'll get some darker greens going back here in the back, and maybe some slightly lighter ones back here, tiny tucking around. There. Okay, there. A little bit of green leaves. This is sort of cute, right? So anyway, so he comes along, and nobody can believe I'm talking to him, it turns out that he wanted to pay. He actually bought the car. He came in with money orders. He didn't have a bank account. He came in with all these money orders. And we had to have a credit app for people, and we needed, you know, apparently in case you have to hunt people down, they want the name of friends, right? You know? And so I said, I need the name of three friends. He says, I don't have any friends. Would you be my friend? Can I put you down as a friend? And I felt really sorry for him. He didn't have any friends, and nobody wanted to wait on him. He was one of those people that just people walked away from, you know? And I said, yeah, put me down as a friend. I'm going to break this up now a little bit here, these leaves and here, these flowers. Just break them up a touch back in here like this. Okay? See? Broke those up. Now, let's put some bright colored flowers here. Let's see what happens. Remember, yellow only paints over white. So we'll start off with white, and then we'll make decisions, right? But let's just put some sort of flowers in here like this. We're going to say that there's some cute little flowers over here like this. And because this is going over some sort of greenery, that's kind of an off-white here, but we're going to say that there's some flowers in here like this. All right. And anyway, he ended up buying the car, and people couldn't believe it. And that's just the way it was. I would just talk to anybody, and they would buy cars. Because they obviously didn't come there. They came to buy a car.
Why would you go to a car deal unless you had an interest in the car?
Well, that was it. And they came to buy cars. And the thing of it was is that I'm going to just put some greenery coming up this way now. Over that one. So there's our shadowy greenery. There. Something like this. Okay. Now I've got to dry that real quick, and then I'll finish the story about the car dealership, which was fun. Anyway, paid the bills.
So would you consider yourself a successful car dealer or salesperson?
I was. I was very good at it. Somehow I had more cars out. Because I understood shopping. I mean, basically, I absolutely get shopping. You know what I mean? You want to, you know, you just... Everybody wants to buy things. It's just, why should they buy it from you? And of course, I really did listen to all those Zig Ziglar tapes about, you know, connecting with people and finding out why they might want something. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, basically, if they show up there, they obviously want something, John.
Well, yeah, absolutely.
And so that was my sojourn into car journey. All right, I have to dry this white to put the yellow on it. So
this is an 8x10 canvas, correct?
This is a little 8x10. It's kind of cute, though, don't you think?
It's adorable.
I mean, for just chatting away here.
And creating it on the fly, might I suggest. We're just creating this on the fly.
We're just making this up as we go, right? But, you know.
This is how ginger rolls.
We're going to do that. We're making it up on the floor. But, you know, I mean, I had some good reference material here. All right, I'm going to just put these over here like this.
So they're not in the way of
the hair dryer. I'm turning this on. And
all right, she's muted. All right, I got a couple more to show you from Tina. We have the Van Gogh stone bottles, which is very impressive. And now we have a Ginger Cook pack, which is the personal art coaching. This is going to be Christina's first. Let's see. Wait a minute. Oh, good. Wait. Wait.
Got that. Now, yeah,
wait, this is real important. Just wait.
Yeah, no. I want you to see that.
I got to make sure I got the right one up there. Is that the first one?
That's the first one. That's what she sent me.
Okay. All right. So now you can talk because you're on board.
Okay. So what happens was this is another, even though we're doing flowers, we're talking about perspective again. When something's looking right at you, a flower's pointing right at you, like my nose, right? It's called foreshortening, so you don't see it. So then I went ahead and explained, because this was originally a painting by Mary Cassatt. She was one of the impressionists that hung out with Monet and those guys, right? She was an American gal, but she knew all those guys, and she was a fabulous artist. And that was the original concept of this painting. So then I wrote how it happens, how critiques work, or, you know, suggestions, is that I then show you how to fix it. So go to the next
one. Okay, here's the first thing.
So look at the direction of Mary's white flowers. You see how they sort of snake? Because they're straight in front of you. You don't see the cone shape, all right? Because so in other words, they're not just all cones sticking out in every direction, all right?
And now you showed her this.
I showed her that. And then I showed her that. And then I showed her the different shapes that she had going, right?
She didn't really realize it.
She did, you know. Well, I said, this is the shape we want, right? And this is these are where the other out... I guess this was the original. These are the shapes we're going for in this picture, all right? So the original had these shapes and this S pattern. That's what we were going for, all right? Now let's flip it back to her first one.
Flip it back to the first one.
See?
There's the first one.
So see, all the cones are going in, you know, so we don't have any sense that there's flowers right in front. So then, all right, so flip it back.
Now do her second. This is her final.
And show the final. Now see the difference?
She broke it completely up.
See? She got that S pattern going, and now she's got, you know, a flower arrangement where we kept some of the cones going out, but those white ones, because they were looking right at us, we don't see the flowers like that. See the difference? So that's what personal art coaching does, and I think it really makes a difference. And that this gal hasn't been painting that long, and I think it's incredibly good job on that painting by Mary Cassatt. I mean, really terrific. Really like that a lot.
Let's make sure
that you saw Christine's picture. And listen, we don't just randomly show pictures. When you send us in, you can say, just sharing my artwork, don't show this to anybody, or I'd like some help. It's okay. We don't show anybody's artwork unless they've given us permission. All right. So now back in here, we're talking about some yellow flowers. So here's a little of this. Let's just tap in some yellow here. This is this cad yellow light. It's not too bright. Let's just tap some in here. See what I've got going here. That's not very interesting, is it? So, all right, so let's put out some cad yellow medium. Because I've used all mine up in greens. Here's some cad yellow medium. And let's brighten this up a bit. Let's just take some, okay, so here's some bright yellow. See the difference? Let's just brighten this up here a little bit, tap it over the white. And if you look at these yellow flowers that I'm gonna show you, the ones I'm doing, kind of like these yellow ones right here. If you look at these, they've got green underneath, so sort of this funny green. So let's make this sort of lime green color. Let's add a little bit of orange to make the lime green color, kind of gray it out a little bit. Orange is, you know, red and yellow, so put orange and green. Now let's take it and add some little tiny green leaves in here like this. Make that a little bit. Let's take some ultramarine blue and yellow and see what I can get there.
Seem to have lost focus on that camera.
Have we lost focus? Can you zoom in on this, John?
Just lost focus on the camera.
Oh, are you going to fix it?
So I will interrupt the broadcast for a moment.
Yeah.
So just kind of cool your jets because this is going to screw up what they see.
Okay, hang on. We're making a correction here.
Focus. too much.
All right, so now you can kind of see what we've got here going. No, such. Is it?
This is him doing.
Okay, so I've tapped in a little bit of green around to tone down the yellow, right? Started with the yellow and tapped a little green, right? All right, so he's trying it again. He's going to try and focus that so you can kind of see it, right? All right, good. Good. I'm glad you're happy.
you want me to be happy.
Oh, absolutely, John. Of course we do, right? Oh, we want you to be happy. You see how this is coming along here? Pretty nifty keen. Here, we're just, a little quick picture. How to just, draw on a bench. See, here, so we started off with this.
Oh, that's much better.
And now we're coming in here.
I thought my eyes were going
and
crazy.
And I just feel like we need some flowers right here, even though we just did some greenery. In the picture, see, this is the trying to see. In the picture, there's not much of anything. But I think we need some flowers here. And I'm tempted to put...
I knew it.
But, I'm tempted to put some purple ones, maybe,
ooh,
in white. Maybe that would be pretty. That's blue. Well, this is what happens when you try to paint with sunglasses on.
I think it's a cool look. I think it's a new look we should go with.
I'm telling you what, let's try for purple. We're going for purple here. Here we go.
Looked like magenta the first time.
Yeah, we're going to go for purple and a little magenta. It's sort of a combination of both. Ooh, pretty, right? So it's not quite, right? So let's add a few little, let's get some white going here. There, let's get some little bit of white. Ooh, like that, something like this, right?
Ooh, like that.
So where are we going to put some flowers here? Let's put, let's just put some little tiny flowers in here like this. We don't have, just something that's living here. I don't know. Teacher makes up flowers all the time. It's good. What kind of flowers are those? I don't know. Ginger flowers. There, see? A few little purple flowers. Look how cute that looks, see? Just a few little purple flowers growing here in the corner. Doesn't hurt. And there. Kind of coming out of the corner here. Now we've got a very fun little garden. I think we need some green leaves coming out this way from our the side here, right? Just some darker green leaves over the path. Like that. And then there's... Probably should just cover that up because that doesn't look all that great. Okay. All right. So then what you do is you tan back and you see I'm kind of looking. You see me looking off all the time. I'm looking at this in a monitor. It's like looking at in a mirror. And what I'm not a big fan of are these big red flowers here. I don't like them at all.
Which
I'm looking.
Ones?
These one? Ones.
Okay.
So I don't really like those. I mean, I don't think they add anything. I need some of these to be a bit brighter, like in here. I need some of these to be a bit, I'm going to brighten up some of these right in here with adding a little yellow to these, right like that, okay? I want a little bit brighter flower right in here like that, okay? So that brought my eye back over here. And these aren't doing a thing for me. So they were in the picture. There were some red flowers back in there. But I think probably what we need to do is push them back with some green. So we're going to erase some of them and just suggest there's some red flowers there. But not this big mass of them. There we go.
And that's the advantage of acrylics.
Yeah, see, so now I like them better. In fact, I would even put a couple more, maybe even over here, just suggest that there might be some red flowers this way. But they're not as big, and they're just sort of off there, see? And that sort of, some smaller ones there. There we go. All right, so that, do you see what I mean? The big mass of red, didn't do it. And what about some green leaves coming down over here?
Apparently you have some hostas flowers that are down by the bench.
Some what?
Hostas, H-O-S-T-A.
Oh, these? Oh, good. All right. So, and you know, one thing you can do is you can get a couple some gardening magazines, you know, let's just flip through them and just add those flowers to your picture. You know, this photograph, if anybody wants to know where we got it over at Paint My Photo. I just found it on there. I thought that was a nice one.
This is a good one. Ginger can turn a burlap sack into an elegant evening gown.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. All right. So I think I want some longer, you know, through here like this. I think we want to explain some of these longer ones. So let's take a little bit of green here and just explain just a few grasses up here like that. Let's pull something over our walk. Now, do we have anything dark we want to put right here? Kind of break this up a bit. There, like that. And then what's not really showing as well on the bench, let me just, this bench, because of the way we have it tucked in here, I want to bring this bench back a little more. And you can't, this is acrylic, so you can do it, right? I want to bring this bench back into here a little more. You know what I mean? Just this way. Just doing that. Just maybe erase that flower there. See? That made it. See how that just sort of fixed it? Because your mind knows that the back of the bench is this way. So we needed to do that. And let's see. Oh, yeah. What else do we need to do? Oh, yeah. We got to put some more burnt umber out. So, yeah, we were talking about selling cars, weren't we, or something like that?
Yeah, you were selling cars.
Yeah, selling cars. The first dealership I worked at, that was a little rough. And I remember, I don't think I'd ever worked for people where they yelled and screamed. Do you know what I mean? And so I had this one manager bring me in to his office and just screamed at me. And just unloaded on me. And I'm looking at him going, it's a very odd behavior. You know, just so funny to me. So just, and I mean, I really wasn't doing much of anything except looking at him going, huh. just, wow, what you're yelling, you know, and wondering why you're yelling. And I'm going to bring this back. Here we go, like that. There's a part of the flowers we didn't do. And later he said, I didn't understand. I overheard this through a second party. He was like, man, I just yelled at her, said everything, and she made me so mad. I just yelled at her, and she didn't bat an eye. She just stood there very calmly, you know, was talking to me, and I said, never seen anybody do that. And what he didn't appreciate was that Cinnamon's dad used to yell all the time. You know, this was nothing. This was small potatoes, right? Yelling, you know, just he'd have this man obviously was having some sort of a temper tantrum, and I was sorry about it, but it really wasn't much I could do for him anyway, except feel bad that he was that upset. And if he had something he wanted me to correct, I'd be happy to do it. And screaming at me really probably wasn't your best result. That was a very fun thing. Now, see how we're lightening up the path a little bit now here? Just so you guys see that? We're just coming in here with our next layer of light coming up under here and lightening up just in a couple places, right? There we go. I'm kind of trimming it out. That's our picture. I think that came out pretty well. Don't you guys think so?
I think it's marvelous.
For doing that. I mean, I'm looking at that.
Considering what you started with?
With a canvas, really, is what we started with, John.
Absolutely. That's
so
exactly
we started
what
we with the canvas.
And you put color on it.
And we put color on it, you know. That's right. We started with the canvas. And incidentally, if you haven't, before we get too far, I really like this. A couple of things I'm doing. Do you see this paper towel here where I'm able to wipe off the excess paint? I want to make sure I've tapped on enough light on these azaleas, the top of these, where I indicate the light's coming down from the top, right? So this is where you stop and look at that and say, what else could I do, right? And you know, and quite frankly, I mean, we did this as sort of a fast little sketch. We did this pretty fast, but, you know, we've been covering flowers pretty well, haven't we?
I think so.
I mean, I think this
for
is sort of
for those people who are still stuck in the winter.
Well, I'm sorry about that. It's hot here in Houston. It's really hot. I'm just going to break these up a little bit too here, a little bit of green, a little bit of bright green here like that. Now, this is where you can do kind of like a little tiny bit of bright green somewhere. There, okay, a little bit of that. Just bring your eye there, and there's our bench. And on, you can't see it, but they're actually, somebody wrote something on this bench, right? Here. There was this sort of, somebody had written something. And I don't know if you did this really big, then you maybe could inscribe something on the bench. Might be nice, or not. But anyway, garden bench, I think that's a good title for this.
Garden bench would go nicely with your birthday gift.
Yeah, and it would, and let's see, let's bring in these, out of these roses, let's bring some lighter green here coming out like this. Up from the top, a few of these, right?
It there, snowed see? All day and all night up in Washington. Port what? Angels.
What's that?
It was snowing up in Washington all day and all night.
Oh my gosh. A snow days, yeah, wow.
Well, we have 80
snow
today.
Days. Yeah, it's 80, and if we got fans on. I wanted to show you guys our masks real quick, if you turned in late. Aren't these good? This is the Mardi Gras mask for this February, for 2017. We're going to be painting this one tomorrow night, okay? This will be on Ginger Paint with Ginger Tuesdays. We're going to be painting this tomorrow night.
8x10 canvas.
8x10 canvas. Dark blue would be a good background color, but I'm also going to have a traceable for this after the show. We'll make available a traceable for this, all right? And then this one here, which is the companion piece to this, this will be released for our members of GingerCookLive.gallery, our members that subscribe monthly, even if you get it for a week. If you want the other one, you can just join us for a week and get it. This is not your Thursday lesson. This is your Tuesday bonus lesson for both libraries, Ginger Cook Live.
Because John has nothing else to do.
Yeah, I come up with this stuff, and he's so busy, and he's going crazy. But this will be available for you guys tomorrow night, and I'm going to show you, in this one, I show you how to grid it and draw it freehand. It's really a cool lesson. It's a really valuable lesson. But I think both of these are absolutely nifty. Don't you guys think so?
I think so.
Really cool. All right. So that's that. Here's our picture back again. And you know, if you figure that we went from here to this, which is kind of neat, right? Got a garden bench.
Let me zoom in tight on that.
Yeah, there we go, you guys. And I would just take a small brush. I bet I have one somewhere.
I bet you do. Hey, we have a question.
Sure, and we're happy to answer questions for a minute.
Of course
yeah.
We are. Ginger, when using a glazing medium plus retarder, do I mix a pile of it with color or just a bit to the brush?
I don't know. Say that again. I'm thinking about it. That I'm really confused now. I'm doing what?
I'm using glazing medium.
Yeah.
Plus a retarder. Do I mix a pile of it with the color, or just a bit to the brush? Just add a little bit to the brush.
Well, what you need to do, depending on the brand, is you need to go up to the website of the like Golden or Matisse or whoever you bought that glazing medium from, and you need to read about how to use it. Because every brand is slightly different, and I don't think I'd mix them together for sure. And it would depend what you were painting. I like to just do it per. I use glazing medium. It's glazing medium, and is you shouldn't have to. Glazing medium is pure polymer, and so for small bits, I wouldn't think you need to put a retarder in it. I don't know. You just you know what you should do is you should have some small canvases like this.
Or even get to 6x8s.
6x8s, and do some strips, test strips of stuff, and experiment, see what happens. You know, your climate, humidity, all that stuff makes a difference. And see it. I don't see if you needed to mix them together. I'm not sure what the benefit would be of mixing them together, but I would sure look at that and see what it would be. And incidentally, so I just don't know. You know, other than that, I would be very curious to see what you come up with, but I'm not sure that I would know that. All right, so this is where we were. This is before and after. I think that's pretty cool, don't you, John?
Ginger, I think once again, even with shades on, you come up with a cool painting.
Let me look at this and take the shades off. Wow, it's bright, isn't it? this is so bright. Good.
Do you have the birthday present handy there? Somebody's asking to see that.
Do you have it handy? I don't
have it. Well, you know, being as organized as I am.
We have all our pictures hung up on walls now. And also, we're going to put up a thing on our gallery, and we're going to have some of our... We've done so many paintings over the last 3 years that we're going to have some for sale. you know, we're just going to put some up for sale, original pieces, which is kind of cool. We thought that would be, and some people never let go of their original pieces, and I think it's nice to, you know, have, you know, occasionally you'll see me give some away, like we gave the angels away, and we're going to have a bunch of the little 6x8s, and you see it yet? John's still looking. He's looking. Well, it, if you want to know what the birthday gift was, it's the thumbnail on last Wednesday's painting.
Is that it?
That's it. There we found it, right? Oh, this would look nice with this, you guys.
Don't you think so?
This would be very pretty. Here.
Here
it is.
I have to zoom out now. Let me get back to my spot.
Yeah, here. Well, zooming this out there like that. This is that one, right? This was our birthday gift, and you can just go to the website. What's neat about this is you can download this. Is keep it in your library. This is our birthday painting. This is tonight's, right? Okay.
They should be able to sit side by side. Put them side by side.
Yeah. See. I think I want to do them like this.
Yeah. There you go.
There you go. It's almost. That's cool, isn't it? So, and then you can start your own little collection of flower paintings. Fun, right?
What brush did you just use to sign your painting with?
Okay, I'm telling you what, this is a 000 ruby satin silver.
How many zeros is that? Four?
Three.
Oh.
Three zeros. Little pointy brush here called a, I can't see it. I don't have my reading glasses. Ruby satin round. That's what it's called, around 00. But remember, if you go up to our brush guys, thebrushguys.com, right, and people will tell you that, they don't pay me to say this. Honestly, I got us a deal where if you say my name, you know, write my name in the code, Ginger Cook, all one word, you get 5% off. They ship all over the world. They carry the ruby satin silvers. You go to teacher's page and then find my name, Ginger Cook, and then and you'll see a list of the ruby satin silver brushes there. And then also, any brushes on their site you buy, you just use my code and you get that discount, and which I think is nice. It's like 5%. And I just bought some brand new ruby satins. But I really love, if you haven't tried one of these angle ones, I love the 3/8 inch angle brush, and this is a 1/2 inch, I think what that is, 1/2 inch? Yeah, this is a 1/2 inch. I like the 3-inch and the 1/4 inch angle brushes. They're fantastic to paint with. Really nice. I think this is fun. So tomorrow night, you guys, we're going to be painting the mask, because we'll be ready for that. And if you haven't done the pots of flowers yet, that would go with this. There's a lot of flower paintings we've got on right now available. And plus, there's a ton on our website of all these beautiful flower paintings. And John, didn't you just release something in our for sale tonight?
Oh, I did. I do not. We have the...
The Rose Gate is for you. Yeah, we just made that as a downloadable available for sale.
And the angel
painting are on our gallery, our downloadable lessons for sale, too. So those
are
new
each
ones.
3.5 hours long.
Oh, yeah. That's, you know, we do this pretty fast, but some of our lessons, 3.5 hours, 4 hours long on our videos on our Ginger Cook Live. We have over 260 lessons, and a lot of them are long and very detailed and involved, but I always try to explain why we're doing something. What's the color wheel? What are we doing? Why do we do it? How do we do it? And I think, because this is, again, I can't say this enough, you guys, this is a learnable skill. It's not a diddly squat to do about talent. It's just a skill you can learn like anything else.
Okay? Anybody can do it.
Yeah, really.
Even with sunglasses.
And even with sunglasses. And it just, you know, I had one student, honest to gosh, he's colorblind, right? So, but he ended up selling, he's going to shows and winning stuff around Houston, and he persevered. He does a lot of, he keeps it to neutrals and stuff. You know, he can't tell the difference between green and blue and all this stuff. He's very badly colorblind. But he's doing great because again, it's a learnable skill, and you just work with what you've got. Okay? So fun. So have a great day, you guys. Hope to see you tomorrow night. Likes and comments are appreciated. And here's the deal. Your comments, that even as fun as they were tonight, they don't show up once. So if you want to come back in when this video is processed, and if you come back and go, it takes about an hour for them to process the video, for YouTube to process it. And it'll be up, and we'll leave this up. And your comments are appreciated, and we thank you very much.
Well, I think that's it for tonight, guys. That concludes another Ginger Crumb lesson, Cookie Crumb lesson on Monday night, 7:30. We'll be back tomorrow with Learn to Paint with Ginger at 7:30. And with that, Ginger, I'd like to say good night, Ginger.
Good night, John. Good night, Sammy.
Sammy, it looks like you've already fallen asleep, buddy.
Oh, good night, Sammy. Went to sleep. Oh, turn off the on-the-air sign because we're not going to be on the air anymore, Sammy. Good night.